Hello again everyone, Khonius here. I just landed in Roswell, New Mexico on my learning to fly tour, so I thought it'd be nice to fly around and see what the area looks like. I've never been here. I don't know if there's much to see, but let's take off and find out. I'm in a Cirrus SR22 little plane, which should be good for our little sightseeing tour here. We're already with autopilot set up and everything, so let's go ahead and get started. So getting used to the pedals and a little sensitive on this plane. Trying to keep us going straight and forward. Alright, go ahead and lift off. I have no idea what the area is like. Once we get to a good enough elevation, I will go outside and take a look.
Skywatch 3237 cleared to land runway 201E. Follow the aircraft on final. Wind 113 at 7.
I believe it's 12:55 p.m. here in Roswell.
Clear to land runway 201E Skywest 3237.
Alright, I'm going to go ahead and head outside. Alright, so just a lot of agricultural land here. But let's circle back and see what we can find. Alright, so there's the airport we just came from. Let's slow it down just a little bit. We don't need to be climbing. Might help to bring up the VFR map and see what's around. Not much to see on the map, I'll just go ahead and turn that back off. But it looks like residences. I don't see any real tall buildings. So I guess this is mostly a residential area, it looks like.
Roswell Tower KH306 frequency change. Albuquerque Center KH306 is type Cirrus SR22 5 miles north of Roswell.
Request some larger buildings down here.
KH306 Albuquerque Center. Squawk 1712.
Squawk 1712 KH306.
KH306 radar contact 6 miles north of Roswell.
Yeah, it just looks like any other kind of semi-rural place. By turning too fast. Let me give it some throttle. Alright, and I see another area over here. So I just hop from area to area, kind of check it out. They all look about the same. Don't really know what to expect here, but this is probably about what I would have expected. Unlikely to run into aliens. Seems pretty calm today. We do have it on live time, live weather, live traffic. Golf course over here where it gets dark green, but I think it's just more agriculture, just different vegetation. Seeing what might be office buildings over here. It's kind of funny how the little developments are sort of organic outgrowths rather than really something structured. I wonder if part of that is a mixture of different satellite data compiled together. Shot I hadn't done before, the side shot while touring. I like that. Pool of water, maybe an evaporation pond of some kind, a treatment plant. Nothing of any real interest, just the name of the place, I guess, and the history behind it. I'm guessing they're growing a lot of broccoli and lettuce and stuff like that. I really do like that particular shot. little bit of stuttering. Probably having to download some stuff off in the distance, maybe, in a direction I hadn't looked in yet. Looks like the highest thing I see above ground is the tower at the airport, not much else. So, looking for something interesting, something remarkable, but not finding it. Let me go a little closer, look at some of these larger buildings. Let's slow down. Distribution center or manufacturing or something? Not sure.
500.
Close enough to the ground, I think I can hear lawnmowers going off. Actually, that's in my front yard. Can't do anything about that right now. Got a little slow there, got close to stalling, but didn't manage to stall. Just gonna take an interest in some of these larger buildings. We must be heading into the wind, having trouble gaining much more speed. Not sure what freeway this is. It looks like it's an interstate, though. I had found a pilot's flight plan online service. I had a great map of Lordsburg, New Mexico, but I haven't been able to get it to come up for Roswell for some reason. So that they're having site issues. And then Google Maps doesn't really show you very much in terms of landmarks. So I need to find a good solution for not only piloting information, but point of interest information. Well, I don't really see anything very interesting. I think I'll see if I can request to land back at the airport. See if I can do that while controlling the plane at the same time. I think I need to turn, get out of the wind. I see the tower, so that tells me what direction to go in. It's really the only thing you can see is elevated. I'm going to bring the flaps up that night. help a little bit. Alright, so let's go up to tower. I don't know if we're already set, but let's go ahead and try. We want to request full stop landing.
Roswell Tower KH306 is 6 miles northwest with Oscar to land.
KH306 Roswell Tower. Enter left traffic runway 201E. Altimeter 30.23 with 112 and 6.
Enter left downwind runway 21KH306.
Alright. Looks like we're going to be making a pretty dramatic bunch of turns to land, but that's okay. So I'm going to go back to flaps down. And just put it down a little bit this time. Try to get our speed down. Let's stay afloat.
Generic 56 Yankee, contact Albuquerque Center on 132.65.
So, not much to do here except just wait till we get close enough to turn. Keep an eye on the speed, throttle, roll and pitch of the plane. Try not to gain any altitude if I can. Okay, we're going a little fast. I'm going to slow it down. I'm going to go down further on the flaps. I'll turn and look. It doesn't have to be perfectly accurate where I enter, but it does help to follow the pattern down, get all the angles right, get the speed right. I kind of need to figure out when I should turn. It'll be a bit... okay. I could go back outside, but I'm trying to force myself to learn to land while inside the cockpit for realism and learning sake. One of my biggest fears was landing from inside the cockpit, and I do find it really hard, so something I'm working on. Alright, I'm going to go ahead and start turning, and I want to be able to kind of see where we're going. That will help with that. I'm trying to keep the nose level with the ground. Okay, so we can just head over there and then turn into it. Looks like our altitude may be okay. With some more thrust, kind of dropping. Again, not much to see in Roswell, but I'm glad I did, because now I have an idea of what it's like. I'm planning to stop at various places along my tour and do these area tours and see what the place is like. I think airspeed is good. I'm going to try to slow down a little bit once I stabilize after the turn. Just have to keep it within that white line with the flaps down. Altitude-wise, I think I'm a little on the low side, but I could also use burning up some of this excess speed, so let's climb a bit. And then continue the turn. I'm going to give it a bit more thrust, because we're starting to drop. Slow, okay, that's the problem. Yeah, we're about to stall, actually. So, let's get some speed. Alright, there we go. I'm trying to keep the nose down. Level is when the yellow arrow is touching the line. I'm suddenly getting some wind. Yeah, that would make sense if that would be level. It just feels like I'm descending, but maybe I'm just staying level. Yeah, it just appears that way. But I always have a tendency to want to lift up a bit and kind of head towards the what appears to be the center of the landing pattern. Again, that can be a good way to burn off excess speed. So it's just a balancing act between airspeed, throttle, and keeping the plane pitched and level and everything properly. I'll have to slow down even more as I get closer to landing, but the turns will burn off some of that speed. And I'm gonna drop throttle just a little bit. See if I can get below 80.
TH-306 cleared to land runway 201E.
Prefer to stay in 70s.
Cleared to land runway 21KH306.
Alright, I'll move the throttle to the center detent. That might be a good thing. I kind of feel like I could afford to drop it a little bit more, but we are going into this turn. That's going to burn off some speed, so we'll see how it does after the turn. Alright, this is kind of a sharp one. Turning and pushing a little bit down on the stick to maintain altitude. Okay, we're not dropping the speed as much as I thought, but we're also descending quickly, so that's gonna keep the speed up. So I'm gonna drop the thrust even more, try to get it down into the 70s. Oops. Stability comes from when I go from having two hands on the stick to one on the stick and one on the throttle. So I just need to get better practiced at that. I think when I eventually get a yoke, that'll be a little easier. It's going to be a little bit more stable than the stick is. Alright, I'm still going to drop thrust a bit. I want to just kind of stay right above the bottom of that white line. Too slow. Okay, well, that's true. I guess we are going too slow. Alright. So let's make the last turn here. Alright, and then just come in and hover. Try to hold off touching down till the last moment. I'm gonna start dropping thrust some more. Let's see if we can just glide in. Not perfectly straight, but that's fine. Alright, so here we are.
Install.
Holding off, holding off, holding off. And I landed a little short and bouncy. Ooh. And I would have hit that thing on the...
contact ground on ONE 21 decimal niner.
121 decimal niner for KH306.
Alright, so maybe I could turn off. No, that's not a turn off. Okay, so I have to figure out where I have to go to get off the runway. The plane has a very sensitive rudder. I have to get used to that. Now they're going to tell me clear the runway when able, but I don't seem to be able. Unless I just pull over to the side. Is it opening over here on the left or on the right? Yeah, that was one. Let's try to slam on the brakes and see if I can turn and go in that direction. It does have a sensitive rudder. On the other hand, it does allow you to make those kind of sharp pivots. I didn't actually pivot on the brake. Alright, we're going way too fast, but let's go ahead and slow down here. And put on the parking brake.
Roswell ground, KH306 taxi to parking.
KH306 taxi to general aviation parking by taxiway Alpha Charlie.
Okay, good. So co-pilot just take
to
care
general
of
aviation parking
comms.
Using taxiway Alpha Charlie KH306.
You can hear the airport landscapers working outside. Oh right. Parking brake. There we go.
KH306, hold position, caution, other traffic.
Hold position, okay. Oh I see, right there.
Hold position KH306.
That's a player? Or just random traffic. Interesting. I think it's just
Roger KH306.
Can't really see this direction, but I assume there's nothing there. I hope in real life that these lights on the ground are made out of a rubberized material, because it seems like it'd be really easy to run over one unintentionally. Alright, we're taxiing a little fast. I'm going to... Ooh boy, the noise outside. Put up the flaps, because I should have done that once I landed. Let's make this turn. Engine of the landscapers almost sounds like a little ultralight, so you could imagine it's, you know, an airplane out here. The perils of not actually having a sound studio. turn and pivot on the left brake. Okay, here we go. Looks good. Roll into a nice smooth landing or nice smooth stop. Perfect. Parking brake. Engine off. Plane off. Let's see if I can remember how to turn the plane off. I don't think it's there. I think it's a different one. Let's see. Yeah, it looks like there's an off position there. There we go. That's it. Thank you so much for watching my Roswell area tour. The place wasn't as interesting as I'd hoped, and I didn't expect to run into all the landscapers, but hey, that's what happens. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to share, like, and subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.